Gotta love this. Seeing a load screen before we even see the main menu. And there we go. Hello everybody and welcome to Prince of Persia, The Warrior Within. This is actually the Prince of Persia game that I have the most experience with, which means I've played about 30 minutes of it, never could get past the first part, and had to return it to the rental place. That's basically what happened. I also want to say that I should have checked this, but I want to say that this game is rated M. So, you have been warned. Let me actually check if it shows in the manual. Which, I mean, it shows so much here. Let's see. 3 pages for The Sands of Time. At 3 pages for... Yep. Totally doesn't show anything. From what I remember last night, whenever I was looking up pictures for a thumbnail, this game is rated M. So, again, like I said, you've been warned. Also, let's see if I can do this before... First off, can I actually change... Oh, yes, 3D. Of course we want blood. This is rated M. It'd be kind of silly not to have blood. Let's turn music down a little bit. Music and effects down because we know how the last game was, and if it's not like this during this game, I will change it again. I'll change it back. But the last 3D port had some problems. Had some problems with the voices, to be perfect, to be precise. Okay, so we have easy, medium, normal, or hard. I'm gonna go with normal because last time I played a game on hard mode. I did not have too much fun and it was raging the whole time. Zone of the Enders 2. Zone of the Enders 1 wasn't too bad on hard mode. Zone of the Enders 2, tried to kill you. Oh, look, the Tower of Babylon. I think that's what that's supposed to be. Well, that looked scary. Good thing we could only have seen it out of the reflection of his eye.
This storm shows us no mercy. We shall respond in kind. Reef the mainsail.
Bring us closer to the wind.
Doesn't seem like a very good idea there, Prince. Still don't know if you have a name.
Oh.
I've got to say one thing, though. It seems pretty stupid to have... Oh, yeah, here's the reason it's rated M, everybody. I almost wish I was kidding. No, I bet you... There's probably more things than that, but that's just the first... First real reason this is rated M is her clothing. Leaving really nothing to the imagination. Wow, this opening cutscene is a lot longer than I remember it being.
Kill him.
But like I was saying, trying to pull the ship in and board them, it kind of seems so stupid to shoot out fire or shoot the fire arrows out as your like hooks. Okay. Okay, the fighting system is definitely upgraded. Oh, he's already dead. Well, that's all I can say right now. It seems like the fighting system has been upgraded a little bit, but we're not really facing too many big and strong enemies like we have had in the past. And I tried to kill myself. Oh, no, thank you. Oh, wow. Cutting people in half?
Man, this...
What kind of voice is that? Is that their voices? It's a pretty funny voice for something that's supposed to be scary. Also... The thing that I've noticed already, we got rock music here. That's great. Hopefully that isn't. I've got to say, if the music starts getting copyright strikes, I'm A, just going to mute the sound for the video, and then B, go in and mute all the music. Because I rather have the game. Nice cutscene there. Nice little. Oh, that's an interesting cutscene. But, like I was saying, I'd rather have the gameplay in the game... Let me actually figure out what I'm trying to say here. I'd rather have the game and actually play it and show it off and not have the music than keep getting copyright because of some rock music. Yeah, like I was saying, the one thing that I noticed already is, I know we've been in a big fighting segment, so I can't say it just yet. But usually after you defeat a couple of enemies... Where the hell? Did you teleport? I guess so. But since we're in a, like I was saying, since we've done nothing but been in a big fighting segment, I can't say it just yet.
We'll never reach our swords alive.
For your sake, you better hope I don't.
Ooh. But the one big thing that I had problem with during the last game was every time you were going to enter a fighting... Oh, wow. She does She does a lot of damage. I forgot about that. There we go. Finally entered another... Ooh! Language there, Prince. You're about to die anyway, so it doesn't matter. I'm not doing too well. Oh, the boot. And... I remember not having to win this, but I could be completely wrong. I have to win it! Oh, good. Where will you send me? Back to the cutscene? Back to a loading screen. That's great. That's fantastic. Oh my god, all the way back here? Seriously? I'll see you guys whenever I'm back to the fight. Okay, back to the fight. Okay, I'm already half dead. That's an amazing start there, game. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to actually survive this fight. I love how challenging yet fair this fight has been this far. As you can tell by the sarcastic tone. Right out of the gate, getting hit for like... Yep, that's just great. But like right out of the gate, getting hit for almost half my health is always fun. Probably closer to a third, but still. Third time's a charm, right? Nope. Again. Exit a cutscene and get freaking sliced up for easily a third of my health is always fair. Getting sick and tired of this game already. That's not a good sign. Especially the moment I try to tap and roll. Doesn't happen. It takes a couple of seconds, it feels. Also, let's backflip away. Also can get hit during a backflip. That's good. Okay, dodge. Don't have any sand power, so why the hell are you showing me that gauge up there? Back away from her. Let her do all her fancy crap. Okay, never mind. Oh, nice dodge. Oh, yeah. Beautiful jump there. Exactly what I wanted to... Okay, all that screaming and stuff is also annoying. But you can tell that they haven't upgraded the fighting system that much, actually. I was giving them credit way too early. Again, it's not fun when an enemy can literally take out a third of your health whenever you can't dodge. Okay, I'm starting this a little early. Let's see if I get cheap shot this time. I'm going to be mashing the X button to get out of the way. But also, I wanted to show this off. It's an interesting little thing. Instead of just skipping the cutscene, they do this. Enter the cutscene, press X, and it just fast forwards. I mean, I got out of the way fast enough to not take the full damage, but the moment she makes contact with, it seems like with one combo list, what? But, like I was saying, the moment she makes contact with a certain move, you just have no control, you can't get out of the way, and you're destined to take about a huge chunk. Okay. And we have... Oh! We have grabs. Huh. It's pretty interesting. And don't need that yet. I remember later on in this game, you actually don't... Hold on, can I? Nope. Nothing good will come of your sacrifice. Back it up. Move it out of the way. Okay, now, see? I hate when games do that. I hate when games basically make it impossible to get out of a situation like that.
I grow tired of this.
If you don't dodge a big attack that's obvious to dodge, it's your fault. But if I don't dodge the one attack, and then it leads into this huge combo that takes away a huge chunk of your health, this is the first fight, mind you. There's nothing else in this game getting you ready for this. So if this was your first Prince of Persia game, you'd be screwed. Kind of like how I was whenever I was younger. I somehow beat this. I think I played it on easy mode. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to figure out how to beat her. Sounds terrible. But I'm going to figure out how to beat this boss. Hopefully. Okay. Something I just didn't show off because I was too busy fighting and trying to get back up to this place. I actually stole one of their weapons from the combo list. Because I actually read the combo list. If you do the acrobats down here and press circle twice, you'll steal their weapon. But since I have a second weapon, triple slash, of course. Okay. This seems interesting. But $20 says I. Oh no, he actually keeps it. Out. No. That. But. Come on. I hate this fight already. This is the first fight. And get out of the way.
I have no time.
She's just too quick at times too. That's a problem half a part of the time is she's just a little too quick. And how, why, I know I was trying to counter. Oh, I'm not talking. Whoops. I completely got too focused into this fight. And forgot that I should be talking.
You have two choices. Run or die.
I have three choices. One of them's just reset. And I've done that way too many times. So I'd rather beat you this time. It'd be a nice change. Also, if you couldn't tell, the sword actually has a little bit of a... of its own health. The secondary sword. And we got back into that stupid combo that does literally about half your health. Come on. Get over here. No, you get over here. So I can acrobat over the freaking lady, Prince. Thank you. Backflip. Pick up the... pick the sword on the ground. Are you talking to me or her whenever you say you gotta do better than that? Because I'm pretty certain that I've tried. Come on, pick the sword. Okay, never mind. Can't pick up the second sword. And every time. Pick up that sword. It's never mind. The sword is right there. Okay, time to get into the cheap tactics. Tried and true. She's just standing there. I'm gonna flip over her and slash her over and over again like that. Up against the wall. That has terrible aim. And oh, she sidestepped it. And she just walked right into that move. Give me your sword, man. You're dead. You don't need it anymore. Can I steal her sword? Probably not. She's a boss. Of course not. And there we go. All that yelling and screaming is getting on my nerves, and this fight is getting on my nerves. I almost shouldn't talk this time. I don't think I really have a shot this at all. Oh, got her that with that. And then get away, get away, get away. And I'm sick and tired of this. Already. Again, that is not a good thing. Why, oh why, is the first fight in this game so stupid? I'm not... it's not that I'm... I know I'm not the greatest at this. Okay, I'm done with this right now. Done retrying over and over. I just need to sit here and talk for a second. What I'm tired of in this game already is this first boss. This first boss does almost half your health in one combo. The problem is, the moment you get hit by said combo, you can't get out of it, no matter how much you mash the X button to roll out of the way. So, if you get hit by the first attack of that combo while trying to roll out of the way of it, you're stuck there, she gets her full combo off, and you lose about half of your health. How does that seem fair? Okay, here we go again. I'm talking before during the cutscene. Oh, here we go. Got caught in that combo. I'm sick and tired of you already. Yeah, I know I could be blocking, but you gotta remember that this is the first fight. Oh, somehow I didn't have...
Tell me when you're going to be ready to fight for real.
Oh, got it. Again. There we go. This is your first real fight against an actual boss, and she does so much damage if you're not prepared for it. Like, to beat her, the game almost expects you to already know how to play the game. Gotten another one of these. That's almost my best chance to win right now. Oh, don't be a freaking ankle biter and attack at the ankles only. I'm over here guarding because I don't... I'm fed up with you. Come on. You can stand there and keep... Did I... What is going on here? I'm gonna... This is just a... Persian standoff? Is that... There we go. Finally something. Got her. Got that. They really wanted to pose and show off her sex appeal, basically, there, didn't they?
The place where the sands were created. The place from which the Maharaja stole the hourglass.
And what if I could reach this island?
They say the Maharaja found portals there, where one could pass backwards through time.
Back through time. To the birthplace of the sands. Something terrible happened when our army traveled to the Maharaja's palace.
You found the sands of time.
Worse, I opened them.
Whosoever shall open the sands must die.
I was forced to kill those I fought beside. Those I had loved.
But now an unstoppable beast chases you.
For the first time in my life, I'm afraid.
And you will die.
I used the sands themselves to reverse time, making it as if the hourglass was never opened.
The beast, the Dahaka, is the guardian of the timeline. You were supposed to die, so it will catch you and see to it that you meet your fate.
It is better to try than to wait here for death.
Madness. Even if you manage to reach the island, you'll still have to face the Empress of Time.
I will travel back in time and prevent the sands from ever being made. If there are no sands, the Dahaka will have no quarrel with me.
Go then, my prince. But know this. Your journey will not end well. You cannot change your fate. No man can.
Okay. Hopefully, I'm assuming there's another cutscene right after this. Called it. Stupid birds. Stupid birds. Get them away.
My swords. Gone.
Now you have to use a stick. Bird, get away. You too. Last time you guys were a nuisance. You and the bats. Are we done? Okay, so, first thing I gotta say, I know this is just a big thing with time travel, movies, stories, anything related to time travel. So, you're saying you want to go back in time and destroy the thing that allows you to go back in time. So, you're standing here talking about that, which means you didn't do it. Because if you went back in time and destroyed it and actually... destroyed it at the beginning, then you'd have no reason for this conversation. See, that's just the big whole time loop thing, and it's what happens in most of the time traveling stories. Kind of like what I did last time, where he traveled so far back in time to where the sands weren't open. The problem with that, he still had the Dagger of Time, which he didn't have at the time when he ended up back to. Anyway. Oh my god, that was just the first area, and I'm already so not ready for this. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give it a like and think about subscribing. And I will see you guys next time.